Well, it's awesome to meet you finally. This is a big thrill for me.
Yes.
First time. 50. It's ironic to me. 15 years later, we meet under these circumstances. You're a coach, and I'm trying to be in the media so far, but it's going good. But
I watched you the other day. You did well.
How was I? Good.
Yeah.
Not bad. You were
well, perfect.
I wouldn't say that, but for me, it's Hall of Fame player, one of the greatest goalies of all time. What? How did you transition from being a player to a coach? Like how does that work?
I thought it was pretty easy, to be honest with you. I mean, yes, at first, I mean, you don't pay as attention to the details that you learn playing, and all of a sudden you put them all together and you say, hey, yeah, that's what we were doing. But it was pretty easy, I guess, because the position, we could see the play coming at us, and we have an opinion on how we should play and the way the play should, I mean, the game should be played. And to be honest with you, I mean, I thought it went well and pretty, I mean, not that easy, but it was, it didn't felt any problem.
Yeah, for me, the biggest thing I noticed with you is you got a ton of passion out there. You look like you're having fun out there. And obviously you're a winner. How do you teach these young guys to win? Obviously you're 6-0 right now, but how do you teach young NHL players how to win? I think that's the toughest thing to do.
Yeah, it doesn't happen overnight. I think it goes by step by step. I mean, first of all, it's how we prepare ourselves. I mean, I think all great athletes, I mean, they prepare themselves really well for their games. They know what they have to do, you know, before the game, what they're going to do on the ice, actually. And to be honest with you, I mean, it's I think this is a start, and it's a very important one, because I think we underestimate how it is important to prepare yourself well and try to visualize what's going to happen during the game, and that's something we've been doing a lot here. I mean, we're doing a video session. We're going to ask questions to the players after. Yeah. Hey, what'd you think of what's your options on their forecheck, on their neutral zone forecheck, on center ice forecheck? I mean, where you want to send the puck, where you want to go, and I think it's something that that helps a player to. And then obviously after, I mean, there's the details. I mean, sometimes we don't pay enough attention on details, and then just for in our practice, stopping in front of the net. How are you going to play the game? And one night you're going to get that bounce. Are you saying this make you a winner? I think it does. Because, I mean, those small details at the end of the night could go on your side. And I think it's contagious after you start winning and everybody feels good. And I think confidence is big part of a winning attitude.
Well, for me, I watch you out there in practice. You look like you're engaged and part of the team. I think that's important now. Where the players think you're right in the trenches with them. You're right in there with them. I think that's one of the most important things. But now you have one of the greatest goalie coaches in the world for me.
Yes.
Francois Allaire.
Yes.
Awesome. For you, do you stay out of the crease? Do you ever go in there and critique your goalies or help them, or do you let him do everything?
To answer your question first, I try to be a partner with them.
Okay.
I don't try to be their coach. I mean, obviously I'm the one that's going to draw the line. But I try to be fair. But I want the players that feel that the door is always open. I love to come in a meeting and let's have an exchange on the way we want to play the game, the system. And I think this is important for the players because they are part of it and they need to be part of it. They all want to produce. They all want to do well. But at the end, I think if they feel that their coach is their partner, it certainly helps a lot. Francois Allaire, I mean, doesn't need any presentation. I mean, you're right. He's probably one of the best coach in the business. In my opinion, he is the best goalie coach in the business. And he's been working so well with Varley since the start of the year. I mean, I understand that Varley has a big part of it because he's the one who made the commitment. But at the same time, when Varley went to see Francois in Switzerland for 5 days and then spent another 14 days in Montreal, I mean, they really click. They really work well together. And I think the relation between the goalie coach and the goalie is extremely important. It's the start. It's how I think you're capable of reaching success. And obviously the reputation that Francois has, I mean, helps a lot. But at the same time, if the goalie looks at you and he's not sure what you're teaching and what you're saying, then all of a sudden it's getting tougher. But Farley being extremely receptive, he believes in Francois's coaching, then no, I'm not talking too much to Varley. I'm going to say a few things. Example, it was his first game on the road in Toronto. And I could sense he was nervous. Francois wasn't there.
Yeah.
Then I said, Varley, just go and have fun.
Yeah.
I mean, you've been outstanding in our first game. You've been playing well in Anaheim, an exhibition game on the road. I think for a goalie on the road is just slow down the pace of the game. If you feel that the other team picks up the momentum, just slow down their pace and be sharper. I mean, freezing the puck and make sure that, you know, a lot of stoppage. And I think it's what Varley, I mean, for us, and actually both goalies have been, I mean, obviously if Jiggy and Francois have been working together in Anaheim, but, I mean, do you have another question?
No, I love listening to you. I love listening.
Just kidding.
I think
I've been talking all the way, but I think they all enjoy a lot. I mean, they our goaltenders have been the big reason why we are 6-0 as we're talking. Yeah.
Perfect. Well, I think having you around is a huge advantage for both of them. And now I'm going to get serious for 1 second, then we're going to have fun again.
Yes.
Back in Montreal, I wasn't playing. I was on the bench, and Mike Vernon was playing against you. And obviously, Mario Tremblay was a coach. And to me, left you out to dry.
Yes.
You as a coach now, if that happened to one of your guys, we just talking about your goalies, how would you handle it?
Well, because I'm a partner with them, I will always protect my players.
For sure.
This is very important to me. I mean, I think the relation go a long way when you're working that way. I mean, I'm not going to judge what Mario did. We all have our opinions.
Yeah.
But I think it's important that there's not one player, there's not a single player that goes in the game and wants to have a bad night. I mean,
never.
But we all have bad nights. And I think it's important that a coach there for him. I mean, how many times you have a tough game, the next day the coach cannot look at you in the eyes. I don't like that. I want to look at my players in the eyes. Hey, you didn't have a bad night the night before. That's the next day. Hi, how are you? Let's be ready for today's practice. And I think that goes a long way. And it's the same thing. A scratch player, I'm not trying to hide from him. I'm going at him and say, hey, how you doing? I have nothing personal with the players that I'm actually, I hate scratch players. This is the part that I hate the most in my job, because I always feel who I am to decide that, you know.
Yeah.
I'm the partner who has to make a tough decision and put these guys in the stands. But I don't like that more than the players, to be honest with you. But I think it is important for me to be nice to them and say, hey, if you don't want to say hi to me or you don't look at me in the eyes, it's your choice. But it's not going to be mine.
Yeah. Now we'll move on to Detroit, because I live in Detroit still, and I'm around there. Everybody's asking me about you. They want to know about Patrick Roy and what he thought about Joe Louis Arena and what he thought about the rivalry, which was the Avs and Detroit back in the 90s. And obviously, to me, you were, if not the part, but one of the biggest parts of that rivalry and all the series. But what was it like for you to play in Joe Louis? And what was that rivalry like, in your words?
I enjoy playing there. This is, first of all, it's a great building. I mean, people are close to you, and they were important games, I guess. It helps at the
all
same
of them.
Time.
Almost
yeah,
all of them.
Yeah, everyone. Because I think none of us wanted to give an edge to the other. None of us wanted to go on a losing streak and say, hey, we got them now. We got the momentum. I mean, and especially going in the playoff, I mean, I still have that famous game in my mind. I mean, we were rolling, beat Detroit, and beat you guys in the playoff the year before. And then that night, I mean, it really affected us a lot in a way that we lost our focus that night. I mean, Scotty Bowman was the master of it, I guess. But at the same time, I mean, we just simply lost our focus. And when we played we came in the playoff, we were not ready, we were not sharp, and even the years after, I mean, we were looking at the wrong thing. We were looking to revenge instead of looking winning hockey games. It took us a couple of years, to be honest with you.
That's a great, great point. I just love, who did you love playing against, who was in the other net the most? Like competing, like at that high, high level.
It didn't really matter, I mean, obviously, I mean, guys like Eddie Belfour, I mean, Dominic Ashek, even yourself, you knew you had a battle. You knew that if you give a lousy goal, a bad goal at the wrong time, that'd be just plenty enough to lose that hockey game.
Well, for me, not to... I grew up idolizing Grant Fear and you. Those are the two guys. So for me to play against you and go through all those battles was a great honor. And it was fun. That was the biggest thing. Although you always didn't come out winning, it was fun and you learned a ton from it. It made us all better. I think it did.
Thanks.
I'll move on from the fun stuff now. What were you thinking when you came after me at center ice? What were you thicking exactly?
Because I was other thinking, than kick the shit of you?
I was thinking, holy shit, what is going to happen? That's what I was thinking.
Well, I mean, it's...
You're a big guy. Like, you were a big guy.
Yeah, you surprised me too. But at the same time, it didn't matter who was at the other side.
Yeah.
It was just the... We just, you know, you could get rattled in those games. Yeah. And I think after our fight, this is where I realized it was overboard. This is not what we were there to do,
yes.
Fighting. It was to win hockey games.
Yeah.
And I think we had a lot of frustration on what happened, I mean, with Claude and in that game. I mean, we simply lost our focus, to be honest with you. And the problem is when your team lose the focus and it's the leaders of the team that lose that focus, it's hard to get back.
Everybody,
this is where
that.
The coach needs to jump in and say, hey, guys, what are you doing?
Yes.
And I think that night was probably the night that there's a lot of things click in my head and say, hey, we're not hitting in the right direction here. We're going totally in the wrong way. And I think that was somehow, I think, a good turnaround for us.
That's a great... That's an awesome perspective.
You know what? There's fightings that's going to turn, you know, teams around and a series around. But also, there's also fight that could do the opposite for your team. And I think the first one hurt us a lot. But the second one made us realize what's going on here.
Yeah, this is...
Let's play hockey and let's be intense.
Which after that, to me, the series, I wasn't there. Dominic Hask played against you. That was the best series I've ever watched. That was a great. That was great.
The one that you guys beat us, I'm sure you remember when you guys were up 2-0 in Denver.
Yeah.
I mean, going in Detroit. I mean, down 2-0. I mean, we were not as. I mean, we tried to show we were confident, but to be honest with you, and no one wanted to be swept by you guys. I mean, I think this is where pride comes into play, and we beat you guys both games there. I think we went on to win the next four, but that was a good one too as well. I mean, they were all very special. I mean, listen, I think we played four times, and the three times we lost against you guys were two game seven and one game six.
Yeah.
It's a lot of games.
It was great hockey.
Yes, it was.
Great hockey, wasn't it? Well, my last question. A fun one, and be honest, you're always honest.
Always
are. Always are. Who is tougher, Vernie or I? And he's a lot shorter than I am. But you can be honest if you think it's him.
Well, it's hard for me to answer this question. First of all, I learned in that fight I had to take my glove off. That helps a lot.
I see you had one extra fight to learn. That was my first.
He got me. I like to say to my sons, I mean, my kids, I said, that was a lucky punch. Come on, guys.
It was that. All that. And I tell him that too.
Yeah.
Well, thanks. This was awesome.
Chris, it's
a great
pleasure.
Honor for me.
Had fun.
And great year so far. Good luck.
Enjoy the interview.
Thank you.